Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. Coming up on this week's show, iPhone 4 launch fanfare, a device from MIT that diagnoses eye prescriptions, and more on the World Tech Update computer contest. We'll start this week, though, with iPhone 4 launch fanfare. Right now, we're outside of the Boston Apple Store on Boylston Street, and hundreds of people are waiting for the iPhone. Just moments ago, the store opened. Let's take a look. Apple's iPhone 4 went on sale in 5 countries on Thursday, and while much of the launch showed cheers and jubilation, some fans who waited in line all night expressed some frustration. One fan tried to reserve his phone online, but couldn't because of AT&T server problems. He chose to wait in line, and then his frustrations began.
And so I thought, well, I'll just get in line. It'll be a fun time. And people at the store all told me, first come, first serve. We've all been here for over 24 hours now, it feels like. And, this line over here, most people have only been here an hour or two, and they're saying they all get to go first, and that we might get to stagger in or trickle through. But it just kind of frustrates us because, you know, we've been here showing support. We've been effectively advertising for Apple all day, all night, you know, to people on the street, telling them we're here for iPhone 4, we're excited about it, and just having fun. It kind of feels like, you know, we're really dedicated fans. Just because we didn't pre-order doesn't mean, you know, we're not as dedicated. And so we're kind of getting treated like, you know, the stepchild.
There were several hundred people in the reserve line that extended well over a city block. The Boston Apple Store promised that everyone in the reserve line would get a phone, but couldn't promise the same thing for the non-reserve line, where some people even camped out in tents. For those who did get their hands on the phone, multitasking, video, and the clear display were big draws.
I'm looking forward to the multitasking, definitely looking forward to the HD video recording, looking forward to the bumped up speed.
The video calling, I think they have a different name for it, but the video calling definitely. And the resolution, like, I'm a lot into photos and videos, so definitely that's going to be huge.
Overseas in Japan, Apple fans weren't in short supply as they also lined up down the block for the new phone. While the queue was still divided into two lines, one for those with reservations and one for those without, the mood was lighter in Tokyo. The SoftBank store in the city's Omotesando district was one of the places selling the phone. This man waited there since Monday to be the first in the world to purchase the new phone, but little did he know that because of a midnight launch in France, the French were actually the first able to buy.
So,
Takahashi used Ustream to show live video of his wait in line outside the store. After a speech by SoftBank CEO Masayoshi Son, Takahashi was handed the first iPhone 4. By September, Apple has said the phone will go on sale in 88 countries. The iPhone wasn't the only hot device this week. Motorola and Verizon introduced a new Droid called the Droid X. It's powered by a 1 GHz processor, has 8 GB of memory built in, and includes a 16 GB micro SD card, which can be swapped for a larger one up to 32 GB. The Droid X also sports an 8-megapixel camera that records 720p video and an 854 by 480 pixel display. Its screen is 4.3 inches. Like the Evo 4G, the phone supports HD video out via HDMI out to your television. The Droid X will ship with Android 2.1, but get an upgrade to 2.2, known as Froyo, later this summer. That means the Droid X will also support Adobe Flash 10.1. Using Verizon's network, the Droid X comes with a Wi-Fi hotspot, so you can connect up to 5 wireless devices to it. The mobile hotspot will cost an additional $20 a month for 2 GB of data. The Droid X will be available from Verizon on July 15th for $200 with a 2-year contract. Diagnosing eyeglass prescriptions in developing countries could become a little bit easier with a new technique from the MIT Media Lab. Typically, a bulky and expensive case like this one needs to be used by a trained healthcare worker, but the Media Lab research replaces it with a cell phone and a small piece of plastic.
So imagine if you can use your mobile phone, hold it right next to your eye, click on a few buttons, say calculate, and you get your prescription for your glasses. The reason why we're able to do this today is the resolution of the mobile phones you have in your pocket is improving dramatically. And that allows us to create a wavefront that's coming out of your display by simply adding a small optical film, something you can just make for about 50 cents. Drop it on top so that the wavefront that's coming out of it can be manipulated to effectively compensate for the aberrations in your eye.
The software that runs on the phone, called Perfect Sight, asks users to align dots on a screen while looking through a plastic device like this. Once finished, the program provides an eyeglass prescription. The plastic pieces cost about $1 to $2 each today, but the group thinks that mass production could drive them down to only a few cents each. The team at the Media Lab have been working on the project for less than a year and will begin field testing it in Boston this summer and later in developing countries. They plan to commercialize this system and initially target parts of Africa and Asia.